And this is the part where Joey makes me look stupid.
The day has come. We're moving the 375 gallon aquarium. Now we've already moved Frank's 100 gallon aquarium and we now need to move this 375 so we can take advantage and make this space even more efficient. We're taking this tank and putting it out onto this stand that I built. The stand's not finished, Frank is below. The stand still needs to be wrapped and so forth. In the future, we'll do that. Tank has all of its rocks and wood out of the tank at this point, saving me hundreds of pounds from lifting it. Plus the fact that we also have to remove all of the substrate within it, all of the sand, there's a couple hundred pounds of that. Typically I wouldn't bother because it's a long, tedious job. However, we have to go through the door with the tank up on its side. It's not going to fit through just like this. The tank is 3 feet wide. The doorway is not 3 feet wide. I think it's 2 inches too small. So now I'm gonna drain the sump and remove all the sand. Oh, I also prepared a couple of containers filled with aquarium water. As you can see here, this is all tank water. One for the loaches, one for the vieja, and then of course another container for the sand. Tank is mostly drained. Substrate mostly removed, only about 2 to 3 inches, probably 3 inches of water left. This is perfect water level to catch a bunch of fish in such a big tank. I'm gonna start trying to move them to their buckets. Man, these guys got bigger. All right, so all of the vieja are now captured and in there. Temporary bucket. On to the clown loaches now, who are going to be relatively simple to catch. However, Gary's here now.
What's going on?
He's gonna help move the tank, but also Gary has never gotten to move fish. So Gary, you wanna move some clown loaches?
I moved some arowana.
Oh, that's true. Gary, 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 Gary.
Now watch their barbs on the sides of their heads. They're highly venomous and poisonous.
I think I fell for this before.
They've been known to take down a full-grown elephant.
Yep, come on, it's a good spot. Swim into it.
We're not gonna be able to see through there.
Oh!
Did the poor fish scare you?
I need to get up higher.
There's more steps, Gary, it's a ladder. Ah,
so much stress!
You don't have to get them all at once.
Okay.
How many did you get? Two? All of that for two? Give me the net. One last chance, Gary.
Come on, fishy, work with me. They're smart.
Yeah, they're really smart. Really fast. They're hilarious. Bunch of clowns. Yeah, dad jokes.
How many did you get there?
There's one. Oh, okay. I only work with sharks, usually, and arowana. Been known to dabble with stingrays.
See, fish are pretty smart, but a lot of times if you just let them swim into the net as opposed to trying to catch them, it's a lot less stressful on them. Okay, now that we have them all in this tiny little container, Gary, come check this out.
So it's really difficult to replicate this in an aquarium, but do you know why they're called clown loaches?
No idea.
All right, so now that we have them in a container that will echo, if you listen closely, they have this mechanism in behind their heads where they can make this clicking noise that sounds like they're laughing.
If you listen closely, listen. Near the camera. You hear it?
And this is the part where Joey makes me look stupid.
I'm kidding. Cloud loaches get their name from their coloration. Alright, so here's the plan for moving it. We have to put it up on its side, of course, to get it through the door. However, I want to use the plywood top as well as the sponge matting for the new stand. Didn't want to buy all that new, just to have to throw all this out. So we're going to take it, put it on the floor, remove this, put it on the other stand, and then pick this up and get it going. Gary, explain to these nice people why we need these 4x4s on the floor.
Joey, we could get it down to that level and then slide it right out to the front part of the gallery. That'd be nice.
What if it scratches the tank?
Well, hopefully you can buff that out.
Stop making more work for me. So in case we need to put it down, we got some 2x4s. They're separated by about 18 inches. The tank is 24 inches, so when our hands are under it, we should have no issue. Main concern is just being able to swing it around. We've tested picking it up. We can do it with the two of us. When there was four of us bringing it in, there's really only two of us bringing it through most of the way, so we should be fine. Main concern, like I said, is getting that black filtration end to this side of the wall. I also forgot, I need to drill through this wall soon to run all the plumbing.
That's just the light, it's fine. This is about as far as I thought this through.
Swing it, go back around.
Don't put it back.
Do you want me to get...
Let's just put it on the wood. And we'll go from there.
Alright. How am I gonna...
You'll have to figure it out. Are you okay?
Hold on.
I feel like I've been holding it forever.
Hold on.
Good?
Yep. Watch. Yep.
Fix that. We should have worn gloves.
It's okay.
Look at this. Look at the compression it did. Paper thin almost. Ooh. To regular. The foam is only there because the bottom of the tank is a full contact bottom, and what I want to do is remove any inconsistencies in the plywood or the stand and let the foam absorb it as opposed to the tank. So for the screws that are stripped, I was able to just jam this chisel in there and just bang them and cut them right off. For the rest, let's see if Gary can get done. Now it's reusable.
1, 2, 3.
There we go. It's fine, it's there by itself.
I don't trust it.
Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Seems fine.
Alright, now put it on there. Everyone put it on there?
Yep.
Okay. So, on there. One step at a time. So the biggest problem is getting this end over there, but it's not that bad.
Stand there to watch it while I pull it.
That's just grip from my hand. I want you to see something. Go suction cup hand guy.
All right. All right, ready?
Now, we will grab it here, pull it down, and push it in. I don't know if we're going to be able to do these things, but... Biggest thing is making sure the seams still seam like they're gonna hold water. Ready? Oh, we're gonna take all the weight. You ready for it?
Yep.
Just a little push it in. All right, it's mostly on. I don't know about Gary, but this is a tank I do not want to move again. Tank is in place. I had to drill a hole through the wall here, and then comes out underneath the sink there.
The sump is here. This is just temporary. All of this is going to be torn down. I'm building an entirely new filtration rack that's going to, basically be 6 feet tall and about 7 feet long, which will filter most of the aquariums, the big tanks anyways. But for now, I just need to get things up and running, and then we can tear things apart and, you know, kind of do it again. Tank is now mostly filled up. My most important factor, my number one priority though, was getting the filtration back up and running. I ran out of hose for the first time in the aquarium gallery's history, so I had to come up with some temporary fixes and rig the overflow so that it could handle the flow we put it through it for now. But it's going to be quite noisy for a couple days till I fix it. Really all I'm concerned about is getting the fish back in, and we are going to scape it, maybe rescape it here shortly, but not today. Again, I just want to get the fish back in and out of those buckets. Should probably check the fish, make sure they're still doing okay. Yeah, they're still swimming around, no floaters, we're good to go.
So the water is a little bit cloudy right now. We don't have lights on the actual tank yet, so it's gonna be difficult to see the fish, but most importantly, we just want to make sure that they're okay being added back in. I gotta say that these guys have gotten so big in size in just a very short period of time. Essentially, all I've really done is, you know, like 100% water change, a really big water change. I didn't rinse out the filter media, the bacteria within the substrate still alive, etc. The only thing I kind of want to pay attention to when adding them back in is if the temperatures fluctuate too much. They will be a little stressed out going from the bucket to the tank, of course, but the vieja looked fine. Now we try to wrangle these loaches. It's difficult to see into these buckets though, because they're black. So we got Gary trying to spot the loaches with the flashlight. Clown loaches are actually a pretty sensitive fish. When these guys stress out, they can get, they can take a turn for the worse quite quickly. So, all the fish are now in. For those that are new here, we just took apart the 375 gallon and moved it. We also used to have Frank's tank here. Frank's tank and the 375 was taking up this entire area, which I thought we could really put this to much better use, possibly build a pond, like an indoor pond, about 1,000 gallons, and keep some pretty amazing fish. So we moved everybody out here. We got the 375 up top, we've got Frank down low, and of course we built this stand earlier, which is gonna house a 180 gallon saltwater tank. In here though, I still need to build the entire racking system and new filtration that's going to filter most of the aquariums. This is gonna look awesome in here eventually. Everything's gonna be so streamlined, much easier to take care of. And of course we still need to wrap the stands, make them look a lot better, and of course be even more symmetrical with the rest of the gallery. Imagine this. All of these stands wrapped in plywood. Frank's gonna be encased in. He'll have a lid above him, a door over there, all blacked out here. The 2000 is black, the racking is black. And then of course the pond is probably gonna end up being black as well. I don't know, I gotta admit that I'm pretty excited about what's to come and what's to happen. So if you are as well, make sure you subscribe if you're not subscribed already.